the starters for Brown University. It'll be John Keogh, Tom Gagnon, and Bernie Buonanno. Keogh with 13 goals, Gagnon 12, Buonanno 13. The midfield for Brown, Tony Stedman, 7 goals. Walt Cataldo scored 8 times. And Jamie Monroe has 5 goals. Starting on defense for Brown will be their player of the year in the Ivy League a year ago and an All-American candidate, Darren Muller, Bill McComas, and Peter Zidlicky. And starting in the goal for Scott, for Brown will be Scott Lowen, 54 saves, 34 goals. He stopped 61% of the shots. On the attack for Syracuse, Tom Corey with 24 goals. Tom Nelson scored 11. John Zulberti, 14 goals, 15 assists. The midfield of Gordie Mapes with 16 goals. Eric Jeschke and a healthy Todd Curry who has 7 goals. The Syracuse starting defense will have Kevin Sheehan, Dan Pratt, and Jeff Desko. And opening up in the nets today for Syracuse, their fifth-year senior, Jim Guirie, out of Annapolis, Maryland, stopping nearly 65% of the shots. There's the starting lineup. We'll be back with the opening face right after this. Championship game 3 years in a row. Will 1986 be the year that Syracuse regains the title? Stay with Cable 13 all season long for coverage of each and every Syracuse home game and key away contest at Cornell and Hobart. Curry, Corey, Kavanaugh, and Cable 13. La creme de la crosse.
Since 1870, Syracuse University has offered those seeking a higher education the opportunity to share in its rich tradition of academic excellence and diversity. Over 300 different programs are offered by the university's 17 schools and colleges. Many of the programs, including those of the Newhouse School of Public Communication and the Maxwell School of Citizenship, enjoy international reputations. Syracuse University, an education for a lifetime.
And welcome back to the Carrier Dome in Syracuse as we get set for Brown and Syracuse. The Orange men with a record of 6-1, Brown with a 4-2 mark. Coming into today's game, here are the top scorers for Syracuse. Tom Corey with 24 goals and 18 assists for his 42 points. John Zulberti, just a freshman, very balanced between his goals and assists. Gordie Mapes tied with him, and Tom Nelson with 20 points. Gordie Mapes really the surprise there with his 29 points.
Number 12.
Buonanno, Keogh, and Gagnon all closely bunched. And the attack doing the bulk of scoring for Brown University. Getting set now for the faceoff. Brown will alternate between Manny Suarez on the faceoff and Tim Manown. And here it is, Suarez controlling it. Brown quickly goes on the attack. We'll set the offense for you as time permits. Tom Gagnon has it now, played by Sheehan. Gagnon losing the ball. Jim Guirie's in the nets. 22 there is Walt Cataldo with the ball. And back outside now, he goes to Jamie Monroe. He beats his man for a shot, stayed by Guirie. It's off the stick, perhaps, of Gagnon. No, it is still a shot, and it'll still be Brown ball.
Syracuse will use this timeout to get their faceoff man off the field. Smith, who lost to Suarez. Suarez managed to get off and get the offensive midfield run almost immediately. Syracuse does not like to have Smith in there very often. They want to, have, of course, have their big sticks in, and it's a real challenge to be able to do that. They lost at that time. Suarez got the faceoff, and they got right off the field.
We had an illegal procedure signal given on the in the area of the bench where the men come on and off the field, and that's a technical call that will put the ball in possession of Brown.
And Syracuse has a man in the box. Will be man down for 30 seconds right away. At 28 seconds left, Syracuse is man down.
Tom Nelson serving the time. Again, Brown moves the ball quickly now in the man-up situation. Syracuse has done a fine job all season in this particular situation, holding the opposition to just 25% success. The attempted return feed knocked down, and now Brown regains control. Number 11 back there is John Keogh. Here's the feed out. The shot deflected at the point by Chris Burt.
Cataldo took the shot, one of the people in for the extra man play for Brown, but the ball was deflected. They'll get another opportunity, but this is a great chance for Brown maybe get Syracuse a little off stride and come up with a man up goal.
Todd Nelson comes on the field now, so the teams are at equal strength. All even now as Bonanno feeds the crease. The shot, the score by Gagnon. And the Brown bench explodes as Brown draws first blood against Syracuse.
I was just going to say that when the penalty is up, oftentimes there's a little bit of confusion as you shift man-to-man out of the zone, which you are in man-down. Who's got who? And Gagnon is left open here. Eventually, we'll see him get the ball. There it is right there. And there, as you can see, nobody on him. And Guyrie just not able to put the stop on Gagnon. And that's a real important goal, as we said at the top of the show. This is what Brown needs to do to win this game.
Every point that Tom Gagnon scores just increases his all-time scoring mark at Brown. Andy Smith on the faceoff now against Manown. And it's taken down by Brown again. Controlled by Reed Overby. Here comes Brown getting the proper players on the field. Coming on quickly is a 22 Cataldo. As Overby holds the ball, allows his man to get into the offense. He has it now. Now it's Stedman, number 37, coming on. Tony Stedman.
Goal by number 4,
Bonanno got the assist on that goal, the two players we showed right at the beginning of the game.
Well, we said that they've got a very strong attack, and that's what you want to look for. Syracuse in their man-for-man. Now Stedman with the ball for Brown.
Giving it back to Cataldo. Syracuse stays man-to-man. Jeschke is on him. Good spin move. He comes in for the shot. It's wide, but Brown will keep possession of it as Keogh is back there.
Cataldo took a nice shot. Jeschke fell down on the move, and he's replaced right away by number 22, Bedwini, one of the big stick men for Syracuse.
That's what I was going to say. Quickly, they get Bedwini in. Desco now against the very quick Keogh. He feeds the crease.
Nice save.
Looked like Gagnon fell in, but there was no call. And Guyrie tries to outlet it for Syracuse. Pressure now being applied by Brown.
And no pressure at the midfield. They let Syracuse get this right across and give an unsettled situation for a second.
Bedwini feeding Tom Corey. Syracuse playing today again without Rhett Kavanaugh, injured midfielder. But Todd Curry is back. This is John Zulberti with the ball now.
So Bertie Muller on him, number 28 from Brown, a good defenseman.
Jeschke,
we'll see what he does.
Jeschke comes on as a down comes off. Here's Nelson. He faked the shot. He comes up with the ball. Now he loses it behind the cage. And it's Brown coming out of there. Peter Zidlicky getting it up ahead to Cataldo. Now the bounce pass looks like Overby on the move. With Gagnon to his left. Sandwiched and dropped to the turf. Swatted ahead, but onto the stick of a Syracuse player. Syracuse moving quickly. It's Todd Curry feeding the crease across the crease. Here's Zulberti behind the back. Corey is to the right of the screen. Nelson has it. Out to the point, Jeschke. And now Corey. Syracuse will settle it down.
Yeah, they are going to settle it down. They've had a couple of fast break opportunities, but now they're going to run their offense, and they're going to take Curry out the top. First time he's been back since that injury.
Pat Donahue comes on, replacing Bedwini. Donahue, another midfielder. Here comes Curry moving on Overby for a shot and a score. A little bit of an overplay by Overby, and Curry went the other way. The World Cup to be lacrosse player for Syracuse knots the score at 1-1.
Well, when you have just a man-on-man situation, watch Overby. He just loses Curry, and Curry runs to his left and puts the ball actually back to the right. Very, very difficult for Lowen to stop the shot, and Syracuse now ties the game up.
And we're even now at 1-1. Again, it is Brown controlling the faceoff initially, but Durgle, who is in on the faceoff, comes away with it now, racing it into the box. Crossfield, he goes to Curry. Syracuse moves it to Nelson, and the ball back into the crease area. Lowen scoops it up. And he sends it out quickly. Both goalies like to transition the ball well. Heffernan moves it across for Brown, number 31. Brian Heffernan, a senior of Needham, Massachusetts. Now Gagnon, number 4, as Brown makes changes on the fly.
Now they're going to take their time. Now, once again, Syracuse get the big sticks in.
Monroe has the ball, looking for Cataldo, coming on, number 22. Stedman will come into your picture now, 37. Here's the move by Jamie Monroe on Jeschke. Easy shot to handle. And Syracuse transitions well. Crowd is really enjoying the way these two teams break out of their own end. Quickly, it's Corey. He feeds Burke. Tough shot with a big stick from that angle. Corey deflected in the air. He battles for it there. And it's taken down by number 32, Bill McComas.
Lots of action behind that cage. Lots of sticks going. We're going to see a flag.
Gets it back. Corey on the delayed call. And into the stick of Stedman, and now the whistle.
They're going to give him 1 minute on a slash, so Syracuse will be man up. A lot of action behind the net. Syracuse has actually had some people open. Nelson, number five, has been open a couple times. They forced it to him the last time. But the midfielders, not the close-in defense, but the defensive minis in the transition game, Dave, have had trouble picking up the Syracuse players, and that's why they've been open. Right there, they just got caught with a slash, so Syracuse will have their first man-up opportunity.
Big crowd on hand for this game. They were treated to a football practice, a controlled practice session before this game. Tom Nelson now, Mark Brannigan on for the first time, number 20. He gets it back again. It's a man-to-man, but they're really packed in as Corey sends it back out. Low hard shot, score! Todd Curry has his second goal on the assist from Tom Corey.
Curry from Corey at 16 from 42, and you'll see the pass right there, right behind. And Corey gets the ball, and Curry is in really kind of a difficult position, but he gets it by and a nice shot along the ground. He was actually played pretty well. Goalie should have made that save, Dave.
Overby was on him, and Scott Lowen, the only returning All-America goalie in the country, was beaten on that shot by Todd Curry, but then again, many people have been.
I think
off the faceoff, Manown lost control. Brannigan has it for Syracuse.
Unofficially, I've got Syracuse and Brown 2-for-2 on faceoffs, but Syracuse has been able to come up with the ground ball and force the turnover. Brown has actually been controlling the draw of the ball. But it all counts, and Syracuse has got an offensive opportunity.
Good ground level look now as Mark Brannigan backs it out. Dergel with a fake going out of bounds, racing into the crease, number 44. And now the ball is lost, taken away by Overby. Here comes Brown. In the midfield area, Manown gets the pass, looking for somebody to spot. Now he shovels it to Keogh. Overby heads to the sideline. So does Appleton. So does Keogh. And now some fresh jerseys coming on. Clayton Jones along with Greg Rogers. 44 is Rogers. Jones with it, number 13. He gets some room as he comes into the box. Now Bonanno and Gagnon. Here's a one-on-one coming by Gagnon, and it hit the pipe, perhaps, and rebounds out toward the Syracuse bench. And Gagnon can't get there in time.
Brown has a large roster, as we see the call, that will stay Brown's ball. They have a large roster. They're using quite a few people, too. They've got their starters listed, and they've got a lot of people they didn't list as starters getting the game early.
Well, I guess it was called a shot, and he was closest to it, right?
Yeah, that would be it. If it stays a shot until someone picks it up, and with one on out bounce, the rule still holds.
Chris Abbott, 25 in the game now. Brown getting the ball in close this game. Bonanno with a good move. Lost the ball as he came clear. And Syracuse brings it up quickly. Bedwini going left and right. And left again.
Needs some help. Yeah, he's going to. Now he takes it across himself. There's quite a crowd there in the middle.
He's played by Abbott momentarily. Syracuse gets Chris Rossi on now, number 21. He'll be in your picture soon. Here's Corey. Sending way outside to Rossi, and now Gordie Mapes will run the show. Gordie Mapes played there by Darren Muller, Ivy League Player of the Year last season. World Cup alternate. Here's Brannigan. Beautiful change of direction. And that was his shot as he switched to the right hand, and then he just tossed it way over the head of Lowen.
They're going to try to beat him out high. If they can beat him one-on-one out there, they'll go ahead and take the shot. It wasn't a hard shot, but Syracuse, Gordie Mapes behind the cage will come up with it and retain possession. 7:49 left in this first quarter. Syracuse ahead by a score of 2-1.
Good lacrosse game. Hope you're enjoying it on Cable 13, Home Team Sports, New England Sports Network, everywhere up and down the East Coast. Tom Corey feeds the crease. Neil off fakes and scores. There's an example of not having to shoot too hard. Neil Ault made the fake. He got the goalie Lowen to commit one way, and then he scored. And Brown University wants a timeout as Syracuse has jumped to a 3-1 lead. Here's the goal again.
Real finesse there. Corey gets the ball off and doesn't have to put it very hard because he's got the goalie way out of position. Lowen actually came out, and that 36 square feet looked even bigger and was able to put it in.
athletes competed in the Olympics. Five of their eight baseball teams have qualified for postseason play. They've had 98 All-Americans in men's and women's track and field. They had the NCAA soccer champion in 1981. They've sent a women's basketball team to the NCAA tourney the past three seasons. The Big East is a lot more than just men's basketball.
Check us out!
Imagine living in a place where the sports action never stops, where amateurs and professionals meet and compete in a variety of events, where four superb seasons of fun guarantee that nobody loses, no matter what sport they like, and where winning is a tradition. Imagine living in a place like this. You do.
And the face-off following Syracuse's third goal, they lead it 3-1.
Suarez and Durgo. I think Durgo's in there because he's got a little better size, and the ball's on the ground, and he comes up with it.
Bill Durgo with the ball. Todd Curry, number 16, gets it now.
I think Suarez was having the better of Smith. Durgo a bit larger. They put him in, and they had a little more luck with the draw.
Curry looking to the offensive today.
Oh.
Scores again. He really wound that shot up and blasted it by Scott Lowen. And now it is Syracuse 4 and Brown 1.
I think one thing that happens is when you're playing man-to-man as Brown is, and you're not sure exactly what your man can do. Watch what happens here. I believe it's Overby. There he is. Watch. The move is made, and he is at least 3 yards in back of Curry, and Overby, 23, just has got to realize that he's got the moves, and he's going to have to compensate for it somehow, because when you get beat out that far by that much, it's going to be trouble for the goalie.
Manal wins the faceoff again against Eric Jeske. This is really the first time this year we've seen Todd Curry this offensive-minded. He's been bothered by a hamstring pull on a couple of occasions, and already Curry has scored three times to give Syracuse a 4-1 lead.
Well, this is exactly what Brown has to do, control the faceoff and get the tempo to their liking. We know they like the fast break, but if you can't get the faceoff, it's tough to do that sometimes.
Chris Abbott's shot bouncing wide. Brown will keep possession of it.
You know, Guiry has looked a little bit in some games, we thought maybe a little bit inconsistent, but gee, he's got a good percentage, just under 65%, I believe, and that's real good for a goalie. And Jimmy Guiry, who is actually a fourth-year junior, he has another season left.
In six previous games, Brown has given up a total of 10 first-quarter goals. Here they've surrendered four, and we still have 6.5 left. And Syracuse takes it away, and they move it upfield quickly. In the big stick,
Sheehan did that so well, 28. He just took the ball away, and now he started a little bit of a mini fast break here with Donahue.
Pat Donahue has it. Now he goes down low to Gordie Mapes. He's got a thigh bandage on his left leg also. Todd Curry's coming on. Let's see how Brown plays him now. He scored three times already. Overby is the man who's been victimized.
Clayton Jones is on him now, number 13 from Brown.
Here comes Curry again. Curry feeds down low, tough angle, shot, score by Gordie Mapes.
That almost defied the law of physics from up here, Dave. It looked like it went around a corner. Gordie Mapes, nice job on the feed, or on the goal from the nice feed.
You could see that time that they were so concerned with Todd Curry that Gordie Mapes snuck in.
Well, they changed. Number 13 was on Curry. That was Clayton Jones. And what he does is he passes off, goes over to the right, and watch him just beats Lowen inside. And that's 5-1 now with 5:48 left, and Syracuse on a roll.
Brown has been a slow-starting team all season long. That was one of the big concerns of Dom Starzia. Here on the face, it's Suarez and Durgle. Durgle isn't pretty. He just keeps the ball usually right there. But this time, Suarez comes up with it. Sometimes they'll keep Suarez in the offense. Right now, though, he's heading back toward the bench along with Appleton and Heffernan. Stedman comes on, so does Cataldo, and El Monroe comes on. Brown is down 5-1 with 5.5 minutes to go.
Durgle getting a little more time now playing defense if he loses the faceoff, coming back and playing midfield defense. There he is right there.
Playing loosely now against Stedman. Goes right by him, but he's picked up by another man on a good defensive play. They feed the crease. Monroe's shot deflected. Cataldo and Pratt Catalo is there. He sticks it up nicely, picking up the ground ball. Now Stedman to Monroe. He'll take it, and it's wide. Syracuse is going to get it.
One thing I noticed about Syracuse defensively, they're getting a lot of help. They slide a lot. When they see somebody's beat, they'll come over and help the person out, and I think it's really helped them a lot. It was a good situation right there to explain that. Monroe, number three, and some guys from Brown were open. As soon as they saw the open man, they slid over and then picked up right after that and got the ball back. So Syracuse playing very well defensively, I think.
Under 5 minutes to go in this first quarter, Jim Guiry brings it up slowly with the help of his defenseman. Dan Pratt going cross field to Desco and too far right into the Syracuse bench.
That's a tough pass. You got that 6 foot stick. It becomes a little unwieldy. You can bring down the high ones, but after you get it, you got to get it under control. He didn't have much of a chance for that one, and Brown will get another opportunity to get back in the game with 4:39 left in the first quarter.
Tom Gagnon, who has the lone goal by Brown University, the first goal of the game.
Syracuse pretty much playing that man-to-man defense.
Here's Bonanno. He had the one-on-one opportunity for a moment. Then he was doubled, and now he gets to Keo. Keo's really quick.
Yes, he is. Very
Cataldo
quick.
With Monroe outside. Switching hands. Now it's Gagnon setting up on the other side of the field. You hear Guiry, the goalie, barking out those defensive calls. Good move on this shake and go. He lost control of it. Bonanno has it. He's being hounded back there by O'Donnell. Sheehan dumps Monroe. Who's got the ball? Syracuse. Guiry up court. Here's one of those unsettled situations. As Brown got caught, unbalanced, Zulberti spins to the crease. And a Syracuse player, Corey, stepped in.
No, it was
an in-and-out situation.
Absolutely right, David. It could have been that. It looked like that, but no, it was not. Somebody from Brown, it didn't have to be the goalie. They had a couple people in there, and you're the goalie, you're in and out. That's going to cost you possession. That's exactly what happened.
That last trip upfield was what Dom Starzer was hoping not to see, his team getting caught unbalanced. Here's an errant pass by Syracuse. Dergel plays it, or rather, Jeschke has it. He'll back it in. And start heading down low. Now it's on the stick of Donahue. He's spinning on a one-on-one move. Intercepted in front of the crease. Jeschke went for it. Stick is knocked out of his hands. Yes, it is Jeschke. And a push will give the ball to Brown.
Defensively, Brown is trying to help out now their midfielders. When they've got a man one-on-one like Overby was on Jeschke that time, what they're doing is when the man makes his move from Syracuse, somebody from the crease has got to jump out and help, because if they get beat out that high, they're going to be in trouble. So they're really trying to help each other out. It really worked for them that time, and we'll see from the end zone shot exactly what the Syracuse defense sees as Brown brings the ball down, coming from right to left, but you're seeing it from the end zone.
This is the view you'd get sitting behind the Syracuse goal, and you see the full field pressure being applied by Syracuse.
And they're all around the ball. That was going to be a flag down here against Syracuse.
And you saw what happened as they could not get it upfield. They threw it over the sidelines, so Syracuse gets it back. There's Dom Starzia, former player at Brown, a great player, too, in the Hall of Fame at Brown.
Syracuse, however, I do not think will be in the position they thought. There was a flag on the other side of the field. I think they'll be down a minute for unnecessary roughness. So that will cost them an opportunity, and Brown will get another opportunity.
Penalty is on number 33, Chris Burt, Syracuse.
Burt, a little overzealous on a check.
1 minute.
He gets caught for a minute.
1 minute penalty against Syracuse.
So another man-up situation for Brown. And we'll see if they can cash in on this one. Start out with Walt Cataldo.
Now Cataldo, 22, out to Keo. It's Stedman, number 37, getting it. They send it to Buonanno, and they work it back to Buonanno.
Oh, what a job Sheehan is doing over there on Bonanno.
Some very physical play between those two, and a whistle now as Syracuse comes upfield.
Could be a slash on Bonanno. We'll see what the call is.
Slash is the indication.
He had a machine gun fire check on the elbow of the Syracuse player, and that's going to cost him a minute on a slash. So he's had to be frustrated. Sheehan is so much bigger and so strong. Took the ball right away from him on an extra man situation. They didn't even get a chance to really get the ball around, and Sheehan knocked it away from him. Got a little frustrated and got caught slashing. Syracuse will be man. They'll be even, actually, here, because the Syracuse man's still in the box. They're going to try to get it in and release him, and they do. So now Syracuse will be up a man.
Tom Nelson coming on the field for Syracuse. 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go in this first quarter.
Brown now has to be very careful in this zone. When you're extra man, down a man, you have to be very careful and watch your slides. Keep the stick up.
And they brought Tom Corey out toward the point where he can really unload one of the hardest shots in college lacrosse. He's got it now. I wouldn't be at all surprised if they try to rotate it back to him.
They'll get it out there and see if they can't get some space on his man, because they're a man down, and see if he can't get a hard shot out.
Zulberti gets it to Curry. Here comes Corey. Here comes the shot. It's high. Woo. Not much secret about what Tom Corey can do and where they're putting him and what he's going to try to do.
They like to tell it. The goalie, they say, here it comes.
Now Corey goes even with the goal, number 42. Curry is out there along with Nelson and Brannigan in close.
Oh, nice
feed,
pop.
A shot by Zulberti, a blind shot, deflected across the far sideline.
They'll get the ball back, but Zulberti waited about 2 seconds too long to take the shot, Dave, but he drew a crowd. He could have taken it early. It's easy to say from up here, but it certainly would have been more effective.
Zulberti works one-on-one, goes down low as Spivey came back on the field. Spivey, a transfer out of North Carolina. Lowen has the ball now. He flips it up ahead to Appleton. Brown has brought 28 players, and they've used many of them here in the first quarter. Appleton all the way across for Spivey, takes a blindside shot, and Pratt forces him back toward midfield. Manown gets it behind the cage to Gagnon. Spells his name G-A-G-N-O-N. Gagnon would be the French. Marker down, the late call against Syracuse. Here's Gagnon out to Monroe. Can they get a shot away? Loose in front now, the whistle.
Oh!
And some spirited
stick action,
play.
Yeah.
Santamoro, number 18 in there. Tony Santamoro.
And Cataldo also whipping the stick around, and somebody from Syracuse retaliated. But it happened before that. There was a slash, and Syracuse will be down a man. So nothing called in the scuffle on the crease, but a slash before that will cost Syracuse a minute.
And there are 48 seconds to go in this first quarter.
Sheehan, 1 minute slashing. Syracuse penalty.
So Sheehan will be down. He's a that good defenseman who did so well in the last Brown extra man and took the ball away from Bonanno. He's not in there now.
Keogh's the point man. Cataldo's the left. Stedman to the right. Gets it now. 40 seconds to go in the quarter. Gagnon to Abbott. Abbott being pushed toward the sideline by Desco. Now bounce pass to Stedman with 28 seconds to go. And Buonanno back to Stedman. Cataldo. Gagnon about 15 yards in front of the cage, and Brown throws it away. 18 seconds to go in the first quarter.
Nice poke check by Burt, 33, actually helped make that pass go awry as he was putting the pressure on the bottom hand, and he poked, and that gave Syracuse now an opportunity to run out this man-down situation.
And John Zulberti matched up one-on-one, drawing a double team there. He's being played by Darren Muller.
Nice job by Muller. Ball's back on the ground.
5 seconds to go. Gagnon coming in. He'll have to fire quick. He does. It's wide, and time has run out. So a good last-ditch opportunity there by Gagnon, who has the only goal of the game for Brown University. At the end of one quarter, it's Syracuse 5 and Brown 1.
Everything in nature has its own trademark, and so does the taste of Genesee beer. The trademark of the rough grouse is the way he drums his wings. And the Genesee trademark is consistent premium quality, because it's made in just one brewery. No wonder they call Genesee beer the great outdoors in a glass.
And try Genesee Light. You won't believe it's a light beer.
I'm a real beer drinker, and Genesee Light's a good tasting beer. Where did you hide the calories?
So you want to play the game? Then you've got to go to the Varsity Sports Shop, the largest supplier of lacrosse equipment in Central New York, including Brian's famous shotgun and Super Light, or STX Excalibur or Laser Light, plus helmets, gloves, and pads. Everything you need to play the game, any game. Varsity stocks a complete line of sporting goods and supplies, fine athletic footwear, and school jackets. Mention this Cable 13 ad and take 10% off anything in the store. Varsity Sports Shop, Vernon Avenue, just west of Midler. One quarter is complete in the Dome, and Syracuse leads Brown 5-1. Big man in that first quarter, no doubt about it, was Todd Curry, back and healthy. Three goals. Gagnon has the only goal for Brown. Brown scored first, Syracuse with the next five. And here's a look at teams that both schools have played so far. Syracuse beating Army, Brown losing to Army. Syracuse beating Adelphi, and Brown also beating Adelphi in overtime. Later in the year, Syracuse will play Massachusetts, and that's the next opponent for Brown University.
As we start this second quarter, Syracuse is still down a man. There was no possession at the end of that quarter, so there will be a faceoff, and Syracuse be well to come up with the ball because Brown has got a good opportunity here. They will be down a man. Syracuse will.
Syracuse will also be playing Cornell, which, of course, will be an opponent of Brown in the Ivy League.
Ball
loose
still
ball
on the ground,
after the
yeah.
face. Desco got a stick on it. Neither team able to maintain any sense of offensive rhythm here. Now Gagnon gets it. Good feed, or intended into the crease to be a good feed. And intercepted, knocked down. It was intended there for Manny Suarez.
Now there was a push on Danny Pratt. Syracuse will clear it. There's the stats. Shots 10 apiece, saves 9 for Guyery, 5 for Lowen. Ground balls 7 apiece, man up goals 1 for Syracuse. Faceoffs 5-3, a statistic that may become more important later. Right now the score doesn't indicate it. Clears pretty even. So actually statistically not bad for either team.
Dan Pratt in the middle. He goes to Donahue. On the sideline now, Jeschke. And even with the crease, it's Mapes. Now Nelson behind the goal. The feed intended for Zulberti off his stick. It'll be a battle between Keogh and Pratt at midfield. Rolls by both.
Keogh did a nice job of holding Pratt's stick down, but now Sheehan has just taken the ball.
He took it right away from Gagnon, who had that little stick right down on there.
Sheehan is just really tough and has done a real nice job so far.
Donahue gets it across to Tom Nelson. He waits for Jeschke to come in the picture. Now Curry has it. Curry sends it back out to Donahue. And Zulberti. And Curry. We're just about a minute into the second quarter. Syracuse 5, Brown 1. Now they move the ball very deliberately. And Lowen comes out of the cage to play it. Tried to stick it backwards. Lowen has it again. He's fair game. His pass deflected, but taken down by Zidlicki. And now, off the bounce, it's played behind the cage by McComas. To Overby and Spivey. Cataldo coming on. He gets the pass. Nearly blindsided by Pratt. Cataldo heads toward the middle. Curry runs him out.
Fine clear by Brown. They did a nice job of working that ball up and not panicking.
Keogh on the move behind the cage against Desco's big stick. Tries to go the other way.
Really keeps that left arm out.
They're all bunched up in front of the net.
One on one.
Almost a clear out for Stedman. Here he comes. Tough angle. Guyery down to play it. Oh, Monroe is dumped to the turf.
That could be another one for, that's another one for Sheehan. No possession, I believe. So that will, but you see, that's one thing that he really likes to do. You know, one of the things he uses the hip a lot. See if we'll see Sheehan 28. He's at least 200 pounds, and watch him come across and see if he doesn't really come up with a hip and a shoulder. He does.
Little Monroe, 6 foot, 175 pounds. I shouldn't really say little by lacrosse standards. Gagnon thought about moving in for the shot. Syracuse really collapsing around. That's a pipe shot. And it rebounds and ricochets right into the Brown bench.
Gagnon got slashed, so Brown will have a man-up opportunity. And they have not been able to cash in.
Sheehan is 6'1", 200 pounds, and Monroe, 6 foot, 175 pounds.
There's that old expression, but Sheehan plays like he's about 230. He really throws the weight around, Dave. Defensively, I think Syracuse has been giving Jim Guyery a lot of help this year in that they play so tough that they're letting Guyery get his experience little by little, and he's getting better with every game, I think.
Now Keogh at the point, gets it to Cataldo, and they play catch on the sideline with Bylund. Stedman now. Bonanno, and once again it's Keogh. Eric Bylund, number 26 in the game, shot by Bonanno,
Nice save. I think it rode up off of Guyrie's stick.
The whole net shook as Guyrie was backed into his cage. Still a 5-1 game, 12 minutes to go, first half. Guanano trying to knock the ball loose away from
Sheehan. Got good speed, too.
Now Brannigan, as Sheehan did a little tiptoe to stay onside. Brannigan into a triple team, still maintains possession.
Now that releases Syracuse's man.
Into the field of play comes Chris Rossi. Gordie Mapes behind the net. Lowen comes out. He's got it. Lowen's out of the net. And it's stolen by Syracuse. Easy goal coming as John Zulberti hits the open net.
Well, that's what happens when you get caught playing out there that far. McComas, 32, the defenseman, actually lost the ball, and Zulberti was just waiting on the crease.
Syracuse goal.
There's the pass
34.
From 32, McComas, and that's the one that was intercepted. And all of a sudden, he looks up, Mapes sees Zulberti camping right on the crease. And McComas has got to feel terrible about it, but they took the ball. It was unbelievable, too. They went about 3 feet. Mapes had it and just wheeled around and hit Zulberti.
Once again, the faceoff stat not indicative of the way the game is going. Manown thought he had it as he came out of there. Uh-oh, no ball. Now Brannigan thought he had it. Dergel gets it. Bill Dergel.
And they redirect it, and they'll give Guyrie now a chance to clear. I think he's better when he gets rid of the ball when he clears it. They had some problems last week, Dave. Gave up actually 2 goals on really sloppy clears.
The defenseman handles it and gets it across. Syracuse leads 6-1. Brown got the very first goal in this game, and it's been all Syracuse since then. Tom Nelson out to Brannigan. Chris Rossi, number 21, being faked to a couple of times by Brannigan. Now Neil Alt comes off a pick in front, did not get the pass. Zulberti, a little one-on-one, duck under, spin back. And Syracuse tracks it down again. Brannigan.
He's a hustler, Brannigan.
Gets it to Alt. Mapes and Zulberti. The freshman Zulberti out to Rossi. He's a transfer. And here's Brannigan. Neil Alt with a bounce shot that bounces over everything.
Once again, he was guarded by Overby. They picked on him a little bit defensively.
Syracuse puts it back in play really quickly. Zulberti checked away from him by Overby. We're making by
Muller. He has done a good job, Muller.
McComas got it to Lowen, and now here comes Zidlicky. He's going to wait.
He may have to redirect it. They're going to get a slash call on that.
It's going to be against Zulberti coming upfield.
Zulberti was scoring in bunches earlier in the season, Dave. He slowed down a little bit his pace. He got a nice one there before, but he had to pick up some slack when Kavanaugh, who's still out, and Curry were out. So he's done a nice job of being able to play, go from move from attack to midfield and be kind of a playmaker instead of a scorer. Right now we've got Brown with another man-up opportunity. They have not been successful and really have not been able to use their time effectively. We'll see if they can't do a better job this time out.
Way outside they go to Stedman. He's moving in against Pratt. Dishes it off to Buonanno. Stedman and Buonanno exchanging. Now Gagnon. He was pressured by Sheehan. Chris Abbott back to Stedman. Brown not taking any shots from way out. Not yet, at least.
They're going to take their time and work it around.
Into the middle. Gagnon gets it. Weak shot. Guyrie's there as Gagnon gets bumped into the crease. Injured Syracuse player is down momentarily.
That's Sheehan. He'll get back up eventually, and they'll get back into it. He's had a bad knee before, Dave. Had arthroscopic surgery before the season. Here's the play. They tried to feed the crease, and you see right there that he took a weak shot. Guyrie had cross-handed it, knocked the ball down, and you can see him sashay into the crease and says, "I was pushed."
And they again, redirect. A redirect back to Guyrie. On that last offensive attempt by Brown, you can see they were still intent on getting the ball in close. Now Gordie Mapes waits for Zulberti to come on and balance the offense out.
Now Brown.
Man behind the cage trying to play possum there. Looks like Corey.
Your percentage shots always come from in a little bit closer. You can't always take all the ones from outside, but that's what they try to do. And here's Syracuse
trying to get it in. Here's a clear out for Zulberti to work one-on-one. Markers down. Call will be against Appleton. And Syracuse will have the man-up situation on the hole against Doug Appleton.
Appleton was doing a pretty good job there until the very end. He got a little too much in the hold, and that's going to cost him 30. But defensively, the close-in defense, Appleton, number 28, Muller have done a nice job.
I would guess because of the man-to-man principles being played by Brown, we're seeing more of the one-on-one game, the clear-out.
Sure, because if you beat the man and you've got your other men spaced out, it's a long way to get any help.
Gordie Mapes. Curry is outside of the point. Now Mapes has it again. And it's intended for Mapes, thrown away, so an error by Syracuse will give it back to Brown.
Nelson was not really close on that pass. Ball went way over Mapes' head, and that will give Brown now, with 8:16 left to go in the second quarter, another offensive opportunity. They will start, however, way down in their own territory. There's a look at the crowd here in the dome.
Nearly all the crowd in the dome sits on the near side of the field to the bottom of the screen. Just about the only people on the far side are in the luxury boxes. 8 minutes to go in the first half. Syracuse leads 6-1. There's been only one goal scored in this second quarter. Walt Cataldo being chased by Corey. Now Muller has it. Nelson is going to bother him. They may take a run at Lowen. Here comes McComas.
They're really putting pressure on this clear attempt. Force a long pass, and they get it across. Nice job by Brown.
Abbott has it. O'Donnell plays him. Now Greg Rogers, 44. Walt Cataldo checks out. Clayton Jones is coming on. There he is, number 13, lower right. Here's the move by Rogers against Bedwini.
Moving a lot of movement on the crease. They got almost a 1-4-1 there. Now they're changing back out. Have nobody behind.
And it's Abbott again. Can't shake free of his man. Syracuse doing a good job. Clayton Jones.
And Brown's going to take their time.
Against Chris Burt.
Now they get doubled. Now a little panic time. You have to
do
something.
And the ball is knocked loose from behind by Bedwini. In close, Bonanno scores. Somehow the ball got in close. Bonanno had it, and he beat Jim Guyrie.
That's the situation that Brown likes, the unsettled situation. And the ball was down. They had the ball down on the ground. And, of course, that attracted a lot of white jerseys. And when they didn't come up with it, Bonanno was open on the crease over to the right. We'll see. There's the ball. Gets over to him on one hop. It was knocked down momentarily, but he took a nice left-hand shot. Pratt got a stick on it, but not enough to stop number six from bringing Brown to within four at 6-2 with 6:51 left in the second quarter.
Looked to me like that pass may have been deflected and affected the slide of the defense, allowing Bonanno to get it.
Absolutely
tough
right
on
again.
The sideline.
Dergel all over.
Overrun by Desco, but Sheehan's going to be back there to stick it away for Syracuse. He gets it to Dergel, seeing more time now besides faceoff duty. Spivey's on him.
High pass
that Curry plays on one bounce.
Those can get you killed, too, sometimes.
Al Zulberti behind the cage. It's Tom Corey.
And they're really taking him way over.
Todd Curry.
And they're going to keep Dergel on. He thought he was going to come off. They're going to leave him in there. And it's going to be Curry way out on top. Guarded by Overby.
He gets by him for the shot. It hit the goalie, Lowen, in play and taken back by Corey. Back to Curry. Now Corey and Curry were high school teammates at West Genesee High School.
It's Jeske now out on top, guarded by number 31.
He's going to make a move. Gets it down low to Zulberti. Twisting and spinning, and he beats the goalie. And McComas as well.
Nice move by Zulberti. Now he takes the ball down. You think he's going to get rid of it. He brings it back, and then he didn't really even put that hard a shot on, but it just goes to show that placement and the ability to fake is much more important than a lot of pizzazz on the ball. Watch him go left, fake the shot, bring it back down, and then take it again. Just a super job by Zulberti. 7-2 now the score as number 34 puts it past Lowen and McComas.
Score is Syracuse 7
and 5:38 left to go. And Zulberti is only a freshman and plays like a senior. A lot of real relaxation in the way he plays. He doesn't play like a freshman who's nervous, Dave.
Suarez to take the face for Brown. And he's in there against Andy Smith, who wins it momentarily. Appleton goes for it and gets it. Appleton
got the big stick. He wants to get rid of it.
O'Donnell was about to run him down. Now Suarez gets it. Overby checks out. Along with Appleton, here comes Stedman and Cataldo.
Suarez also may get out here.
Monroe comes on now, replacing Suarez. Jamie Monroe. Stedman gets it. Monroe wanted it as he came in from the right angle. Blooped in the air, intended for Monroe, taken by Gagnon. Now Buonanno. 7-2, Syracuse, one-on-one. Shovel shot played by Gary. He wings it over now to Jeschke. Now Gordie Mapes, poke check away by McComas. Zidlicky goes back to get it.
McComas, number 32, really did a nice poke check, and that put the ball on the ground. Syracuse not able to recover, and Brown, now a clearing attempt. One thing I noticed on that last faceoff when Brown eventually came up with it, Dave, since they don't have the fast break, and they have to run and get their offensive midfielders on, it gives Syracuse a chance to get their big sticks on. So they have not been able to get that mismatch on a fast break against Syracuse with their short sticks out.
4.5 minutes to go in the first half. Here's the pass to Cataldo, leaving him back for Monroe. Once again, we have not seen very many outside shots, if any, taken by Brown. Stedman, they give him some room to work with. One-on-one against Bedwini. Here's a rebound. O'Donnell shoves his body in there.
We get a push with no possession. Brown will retain the ball. They're really trying to feed the crease, and it's very crowded in there. Cataldo, number 22, was the man they tried to get the ball into. Syracuse just will collapse and put their sticks on him, and it's really tough for Brown to feed the crease. They can't beat him out one-on-one, and that's what they're looking to do right now.
Keogh gave it up, looked for the return pass. It was not forthcoming. Now Stedman and Buonanno. Buonanno and Gagnon have the goals for Brown. Under 4 minutes to go in the first half. 7-2, Syracuse. Buonanno gets it now. And here's Gagnon. Overthrowing Stedman.
Courtesy of Sheehan again.
Batted onside. And Stedman run off the play. Bodies being thrown around liberally. Here's Monroe with an avenue. He feeds and it goes
Sheehan
by Keogh.
Sheehan just on that last play, he knocked the ball out, started the ball up at the midfield line for Syracuse. Brown came back up with it, and Sheehan then knocked down the last pass attempt. He is just a super defensive player and is having a great game against Brown today. Brown not out of it yet. A lot of time left, and but they need a goal here or two to get back in it before halftime and hold Syracuse to 7.
Syracuse's highest output of the year, 21 against Cortland State, 19 in their last game against Adelphi. Here's Buonanno and Gagnon. The two exchange again. Keogh to Abbott. Buonanno. What about the Syracuse defense?
Syracuse just doing a nice job. They're just keeping them, making them force the ball outside, and they're not going to take that long shot. So they're being patient also. Brown's doing a nice job, not getting upset, and they're going to get another shot at this one.
Off the stick of Guyry. 2:18 to go.
That's important to be patient. Syracuse, as we said, playing good defense, but Brown in this last flurry right here, not taking any bad shots, and they're going to take their time, run their offense.
Again, it's Gagnon and Buonanno. Out to the point, Keogh. He's clobbered, dropped, separated from the ball. And rushing back is Rogers as a stick of O'Donnell goes tumbling across midfield. Syracuse stays onside with Corey, getting it to Mapes. They look for a man filling the middle. And there is a call that will go against Brown.
Syracuse able to get down and hustle, pick up a push. Now they'll get an opportunity with 1:54 left to see if they can get another goal up. As I said, Brown still very much in this game. Their offense has kind of slowed down a bit, although they really, with only two goals, they have not done a lot of scoring, but they have not been able to control the ball like they did before. It's Muller out, number 28 for Brown, on number 20 for Syracuse, Mark Brannigan.
Brannigan still played by Muller.
They got to clear out. Syracuse had a whole bunch of people there. When they're playing man-to-man, you'd quite a crowd.
Finally, he spots Rossi. Rossi beats a man, gets it back to Brannigan, spun around, knocked down, and the flag is thrown. And so we'll get another call going against Brown.
Caught him on the head. Cost him one. So Syracuse should be man up for 1 minute with 1:23 left
Brown
in the half.
Number 20, Doug Appleton, 1 minute slashing. Brown penalty.
Doug Appleton drew the penalty, the 1 minute slash. Now we'll see the Syracuse man advantage. 46% success rate coming into today's game. In close, Zulberti. Same kind of shot he worked before. This time they smothered him and he fell into the crease, so Brown gets it.
He doesn't know exactly what happened, looking at Corey and saying, wasn't I in the right place? What happened? At any rate, he ended up in the crease, and they're discussing exactly whether that should have been a sidearm pass or a sidearm shot. He is drawing a lot of attention, and when you're in that situation near the crease, you might want to bring the stick down out to the side. He didn't get an opportunity then, so the score remains the same.
With 1 minute and 5 seconds left, Reed Overby will begin the action.
And Syracuse is going to be right on top of him, being man up. They're going to play right on the ball.
Des goes on him, stride for stride, knocks it away. Overby inadvertently knocks it back toward his own cage. Gordie Mapes digging against Muller. Muller has it.
Syracuse hustling here. They're man up.
Chris Burt's all over the field, all over Muller. Now McComas. He'll be challenged. Taken away by Zulberti. The net is open. Zulberti can't control. Now Desco does.
Yeah, that big stick attracts a lot of attention. It's back on the ground again.
Or he did. There's a very obvious
slash
stick into the chest of McComas by Desco.
Yeah, Desco's going to pick up a penalty on that. And Brown now, 33 seconds left. They can't get a shot off. It's important if you're man up and you can, in that situation, you can retain possession, and there's no face-off, and the team with the ball will retain the ball.
And we'll get a timeout taken by Brown as they want to get off one good shot before the half comes to an end. With 33 seconds left, Syracuse leads Brown 7-2.
Attention. The zoo will open in 5 minutes.
My lines! I can't remember my lines.
My makeup!
Ba 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 boo.
Okay, guys, this way.
Wrong way, guys. Now go in, Melvin.
Hey, this place is a zoo.
Visit your zoo and see how the stars live.
Nine of their student athletes competed in the Olympics. Five of their eight baseball teams have qualified for postseason play. They've had 98 All-Americans in men's and women's track and field. They had the NCAA soccer champion in 1981. They've sent a women's basketball team to the NCAA tourney the past three seasons. The Big East is a lot more than just men's basketball.
Check us out!
Three seconds to go. Dave Cohen, Dale Dreipulcher with you on Cable 13 in Central New York. Home Team Sports in the Middle Atlantic States, New England Sports Network. Brown University took the timeout, and very obviously they'd like to set up one good play to result in one good shot. Here we go. Keogh has it near midfield, gets it ahead to Stedman, played by O'Donnell. Stedman's going to carry it behind the cage.
Now they weren't man up. They had a man in the penalty box. Now they are man up when they got the ball into the restraining area.
16 seconds to go as Abbott carries it into the box. Now Keogh, 10 seconds to go. 7 seconds. They may not get a shot of any kind.
Now if they hold the ball, they'll get possession. That's what they're playing for. That's what they're playing for. They'll no longer will have a face-off. Brown will have possession to
and
start the second
Brown
half.
Contending there was a trip right at the final buzzer.
At the end of the
but there was no call either way. So the end of the first half of the score, Syracuse 7 and Brown 2.
It's really nice out here, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great. Back to nature, huh?
Hey, did you catch anything yet?
Wait, I think I've got something. Yeah, Kermit, I got... Kermit? That's the third can I caught today. How'd those things get in there?
Well, people sometimes wander by and just toss stuff into the water. And there's a lot of other stuff that people put in there that you can't see. That's what pollutes the water, you know?
Why would they do that?
I don't know. I guess people just don't think about it.
Well, don't they understand how important clean water is to fish in and to swim in and to make a decent glass of lemonade with?
Yeah, we all forget sometimes. Water is something we have to conserve and keep clean.
Sounds easy enough.
You know, if you'd like some free tips from my friends at the National Wildlife Federation on how you can use water wisely, write to Kermit, National Wildlife Federation, Washington, D.C., 20036.
Who are you talking to?
Right now, many of our neighbors are ill or injured and need your help. Blood donations across the nation have fallen and supplies are dangerously low. You can help. Please call your local community blood center for an appointment or sign up to participate in the next blood drive at work. Those of us who have received blood know that these donations truly are a gift of life. You can make all the difference.
Tradition has always been at the heart of Syracuse University lacrosse. The great athletes that played on earlier teams shared the same pride and victory that my teammates and I do. I'm Brad Kotz, and I played for the Orange. For me, winning the NCAA championship was an experience I'll never forget. It's hard to describe the feeling you get representing your school and the community you grew up in. Thanks, Syracuse, for all you do for SU athletics.
Back in the Carrier Dome, we're at the half, and Syracuse is leading Brown University by a score of 7-2. Dave Cohen along with Dale Dreipulcher, and it was the first half in which Brown scored the first goal of the game using their fast break style of play, but Syracuse came back to dominate after that.
Syracuse dominated. Offensively, we know what they can do. I'm very, not surprised, but Syracuse has to be pleased with how well they're playing defensively. Sheen's having a great game. They're knocking the ball down. They're losing faceoffs, but they managed to come back from it defensively, taking the ball away from people after they get a fast break on them. So Syracuse got to be very pleased with the way they're playing defensively. Offensively, we expect that from them. Brown's going to have to work a little harder offensively and get some points on the board, or they're not going to come back.
You know, Dale, before the game, we talked about Tom Curry as the man that Brown had to contend themselves with and had to worry about stopping. Instead, it has been Todd Curry, same high school, same breeding. And Curry is a world-class lacrosse player. He has 3 goals in the first half. And at one point in the game, he had outscored Brown by himself at 3-1.
You know, and he has a bad ankle, or had a bad ankle, which is why he missed the last couple of games. I didn't think he'd come back. I thought it might be a little slower recovery time, but he has just, as you said, put on a world-class exhibition today of scoring, and obviously the ankle's not bothering him any.
Let's see if we can take a look now at one of those 3 goals scored by Todd Curry. He wears number 16, and he's worked one-on-one.
Yeah, they just go right out, and they're going to give him the ball, and he takes way wide and then just comes back. and takes a left-handed shot, and he beats the goalie cleanly, and Overby, number 23, didn't have a chance. And that's one of the things that Brown is going to have to work on. If you're going to get beat out that far, you're going to be in trouble. And if you give help, then there's somebody open on the crease. So Syracuse offensively has had their way with Brown.
So three goals in the first half by Todd Curry, and Syracuse leading 7-2 at the half. And we want to take a look at the halftime statistics and see just what they tell besides what the scoreboard says so far. It's a 7-2 game. Syracuse, by the way, with a record of 6-1 coming in, and the Brown University with a record of 4-2. And let's look at the first half stats as Syracuse has that 7-2 lead.
The shots are pretty even, but you get down to saves. Syracuse Guyry is also having a good game, 14 saves. Ground balls even, man-up goals pretty close. Face-offs, a statistic that, you know, is not indicative of the game, but Syracuse is going to have to worry about that as the season wears on. Clears even. Statistically, a fairly even game, but Syracuse obviously in command. Let's look for Brown to come back and get some quick goals.
Syracuse has been able to get the one-on-one opportunities that Brown has not had their way. And so at the half, Syracuse leads 7-2. We'll be back with the second half faceoff after we look at this goal by John Zulberti, a great one-on-one effort that'll take us to this goal here, and we'll come back with a second half face right after this. They've been to the national championship game 3 years in a row. Will 1986 be the year that Syracuse regains the title? Stay with Cable 13 all season long for coverage of each and every Syracuse home game and key away contest at Cornell and Hobart. Curry, Corey, Kavanaugh, and Cable 13. La creme de la crosse.
You know, the great outdoors and Genesee beer were made for each other. Now, isn't that an inviting glass of beer? Like a white-tailed deer bounding across a meadow, Genesee beer has a style all its own. Outdoor freshness, outstanding quality. No wonder they call Genesee beer the great outdoors in a glass.
And try Genesee Light. You won't believe it's a light beer.
I like it a lot, and I'm very shocked that it is a light beer. Yeah. It's the first light beer I've ever liked. A toast to Genesee.
Hi, I'm Ben Donato, your Southwest County Ford dealer. Showroom in Skinny Atlas, New York.
Attention, the zoo will open in 5 minutes.
My lines, I can't remember my lines.
My makeup.
Ba 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 ba.
Okay, guys, this way.
Wrong way, guys. Next going, Melvin.
Hey, this place is a zoo.
Visit your zoo and see how the stars live.
Now the second half will begin without a face-off. There was a man-up situation at the end of the first half, and Brown University will control as we begin quarter number three. Syracuse leads it 7-2. Tom Stedman to Buonanno. Keogh out to Abbott. Out to the point it goes to Cataldo. Brown looking very smart as they move the ball to begin quarter number three. They need to draw first blood here and really get some momentum back.
They have not been able to really work that ball in. They're going to take
an outside
shot. Yep.
And Gagnon beats the goalie, Guyry. We were wondering when Brown would go to that kind of offense, and there it was. So once again, they get on the scoreboard quickly as it is now a 7-3 game.
That's just a low shot by Gagnon out at the point. You see, look at all the room as they were man down, and there's just that low shot that's going to hook
Brown
in there,
goal.
And that gets Brown right back in the game, 7-3.
Scored by number four, Tom Gagnon, assisted.
Suarez and Durgle will face off. Once again, Suarez wins the face. He's got a head of steam as Chesky knocks the ball away. It goes high in the air, taken down by Sheehan. Loose ball. Brown is really coming out, throwing their weight and their sticks around. Durgle in pursuit. Along with Corey, Durgle is going to dribble it down the sideline. It's still in play as he falls out. picked up by Muller. Furious pace to begin quarter number three. Muller has it knocked away by Durgle. Muller gets it back. Down to two knees to play. It is Appleton. Appleton redirected. McComas.
Everybody even now, but they're waiting for all the changes to be made at the midfield, and McComas is going to send it back to Lowen, and they're going to wait until everybody's set.
Now Lowen comes upfield with Stedman on the left sideline getting the ball now. Here comes Stedman racing across. He went by Corey. And now things settle down somewhat. 7-3 game. Syracuse leading. Here's the move by Stedman. Made a lot of fakes, but did not fake his man out. Gagnon. Moving and having it poke checked away by Sheehan. Sheehan is tripped from behind by Gagnon.
That'll cost him a minute. That you can see exactly what we were talking about and how valuable Sheehan has been in this game. As Lowen, Gagnon had the ball out, and it was just poke checked away by Sheehan, and he starts a fast break all by himself, avoids the check, and then you see the trip right there. Sheehan really has been a great force defensively and starting the fast break for Syracuse. Right now, they're going to give the ball to Nelson.
We're in the opening 2 minutes of the second half. Here comes Tom Nelson, and a whistle momentarily stops the play as the cage was knocked a kilter.
Official says, okay, let's go. And now we got a horn.
By the way, the referee today, Jim O'Hara, Nate Foote, the umpire, and Phil Natoli, the bench official.
That was Nate Foote we saw signaling to let's get the game going. Lacrosse, fast-moving game. They don't like to take a lot of time. And Syracuse now has the ball.
Brannigan gets it to Corey. Man in the middle is Nelson. Todd Curry exchanging with Gordie Mapes. And now Brannigan in the slot is Zulberti. Here's Corey. Nelson switching hands, feeding in close. A little touch shot. Corey plays it back for Syracuse. Loops it over everybody to Curry. Cross everybody to Brannigan. Low shot. And that ricochets across the far sideline. They used to call that an Indian shot.
That's right. And Brown still has a man in the box, in the penalty box. So they are going to be zoning it up and trying to keep Syracuse away from the cage.
And once again, they work it to Brannigan. Zulberti is behind the net as the feeder. Here's a pass deflected, taken away by Appleton of Brown. Regained by Brannigan. Sends crossfield to Corey. He winds. He passes instead to Curry. And he tried to backhand the ball into the crease to Zulberti.
They were just even. Sheehan with the ball. They didn't know they were even, and they really cheaped the ball down the field. And that'll be off Syracuse.
Throws it out of bounds as he tried to get it ahead to Brannigan.
Well, you can see that Brown was sick of having the ball in their territory. They just got rid of it. At that time, they had been even, but they wanted to make sure that Syracuse did not pick up a goal.
So we have a 7-3 game, 3 minutes into the third quarter. Dave Cohen along with Dale Dreipolter. And Jamie Monroe splitting the defense. However, a call goes against Brown.
Held the ball against his chest. That was the old Jimmy Brown move, but that's outlawed. You can't do that. Keeps the ball from coming out.
Tom Starzia, the Brown coach, with a red sweater.
I don't think I've seen that call in a long time. Curry has the ball now, number 16. Coming off that injury, has had three goals in the first half.
7-3 is the score. Syracuse leading. At one point, they had a 6-1 lead. Todd Curry, they give him a lot of room to work one-on-one against Appleton. Stutter step, reversing his field. Now he feeds Corey. Low shot. And it's deflected out of bounds. Syracuse keeps it.
Well, you see what happened there. McComas, 32, slid up to help out and take on Curry. And then they fed Corey right away when they see the open man. Nice move. McComas, nice check, but maybe a little bit too vigorous on that. That's going to cost him a push, but he was doing a job on Corey, but got detected pushing.
He wasn't going for the ball. He was more concerned about playing Corey. And he gave him that shove. Mapes comes on, Corey goes off.
See if we can pick it up. There's Corey, 42 of the ball. McComas pushed him right there. A little too much with the hand, and that's going to give Syracuse this opportunity right here.
Zulberti tries to go off the pick. Played well defensively there by McComas, and back outside it goes to Curry. Here's the move coming in close. The feed. Intended there for Donahue. Sticks it back to Nelson. Unsettled situation. They get it. They try to get it to Jeschke. And it went past him, so Brown gets it.
Spivey was there with a big stick, number 39. Jeschke thought he was going to get it. He was surprised. It came by Spivey, went out of bounds. Brown ball. Stedman with it, 37.
Brown University, by the way, plays their games on Stevenson Field, a natural grass field, but they have the Warner Roof, an artificially surfaced field, to play on, so they're familiar with this kind of surface. Monroe has it taken away by O'Donnell. Guanano took a hack at it, so did Gagnon. And a defenseman losing it behind the Syracuse cage.
That's off of Brown, too, I believe. It's off of Gagnon, so the Syracuse ball.
Gagnon pleads his case, going down to his knees. Disagrees with the call, so does Keogh, number 11.
Yeah, right. I think it was a good call. But Brown has really come out and played very, very with a lot of intensity this third quarter. Come up with one goal.
Dale, I mentioned earlier that Brown had actually played the very first lacrosse game in the Dome. That was against Hobart a couple of years ago. Nobody on this present team was on the Brown squad at that time. Gordie Mapes works against Zidlicky. And gets away from him, and he tried to wind it inside and got a pipe.
Ooh. Mapes took a shot on the head. No call. Fast break Brown.
Here come the Bruins across midfield. 10 minutes to go, third quarter. And still in control now, Gagnon.
That was Overby who ran the ball all the way down. Big stick man.
Sheehan playing Gagnon back there. Zidlicky gets it to Clayton Jones, number 13. Stadelmeyer coming on for the first time. Abbott comes on with him. Marty Stadelmeyer. He's a junior out of Yorktown Heights, New York.
We're just running in isolation, 1-4-1.
Clayton Jones is buried in the crease. Abbott lost sight of the ball.
Boy, they're going right at Syracuse. When the ball's down, they're going after it.
And who got it last? Abbott hit it last, so it is taken by Syracuse.
Both teams going to the body, and that really got rough down there. See if we can see it. They head for the crease. There's the stick check down, and there's the body applied. Just let you know, if you're going to come to the crease, this is what's going to happen.
John Keogh's taking a run over in the vicinity of the Syracuse man. They throw back behind him to Brannigan. Appleton's on him. Rossi brings it across. Rossi down to Corey. Loses it off his stick out of bounds.
Syracuse has been a little sloppy down there offensively the last couple times. But they're going to make Brown work it all the way back up because they've been playing very, very tough defensively. When they get that ball down, there's Syracuse jerseys all over it.
Good move by Stedman, but he holds up. Nearly threw it behind Cataldo. Now Lowen looping it back to Stedman. Dangerous pass, the kind that results in a blind hit. Stedman nearly took one. Cataldo loses stick and ball.
Fans love it. Off Brown, I believe. Yes, off Cataldo.
8:41 to go, third quarter.
Fans right into this one in the third quarter. They like the body action. You know, they say that in the big-time lacrosse, Division I lacrosse, it's more finesse. But fans like to see that body contact every once in a while. There may be a face-off. They say there's no possession. I don't know what they're trying to determine exactly where the ball is going to go from. There it is.
Syracuse will have possession. Chris Rossi has it. Gagnon and Spivey set to double team him. And he throws it way down for Corey, or make it Zulberti. Swats it to Alt. Coming in, he gave up the shot. Nelson takes the shot and a delayed call.
Too flat.
I really thought Ault was going to take that shot.
I think Brown did too. And at the last minute, he passed it off. It was kind of an unsettled situation. And now it'll be a man-up situation. Brown detected on a slash. I think it was Zelicki that picked it up 40.
The stars are with his assistants, Mike Caravetta, Peter Lasagna, Dan McKee.
Brown, 1 minute, splash.
Brannigan now, Syracuse man up.
We just checked that was Spivey that picked up the penalty.
Nelson's in the slot, Brannigan is outside. Corey, Zulberti. Now they rotate it to Curry and back to Brannigan. Nelson and Mapes in close, that's a shot. Syracuse will retain it.
That was a far out shot by Corey. He's got a hard one.
How do you mean that, literally or figuratively?
Really far out. Oh, that's...
Oh, they overthrew Corey, who was one-on-one. He gets it back to Brannigan. Across the zone, he goes to Curry, a bullet.
Well, you talk about Corey having a hard shot. That was Curry, 16, who put that one in. I believe that's his fourth goal. See if we can pick it up on replay. Here's the pass across. Brannigan makes a long pass, and Curry's just waiting for him with that right-handed crank. And you see the reaction. The goalie was good, but the ball went by so fast he didn't have a chance. And Brannigan will pick up the assist on that. 8-3 now for the Orange. There's the face-off stat, though. A bit dismal for Syracuse. Brown doing a nice job. They get 65% of their face-offs, so they have during the year. I'd say they're just about on their average.
So it's Syracuse on top, 8-3. Todd Curry with four goals in the game. And Syracuse gets it back. They look for more. A tendency of the Syracuse team has been to score in bunches. Nearly an open net.
Muller,
Gordie Mapes went down low.
Muller, 28, went down low with him and helped out Lowen, and they stopped the shot.
Curry and Suarez. Curry pleading his case. Four goals for Todd Curry, equaling his career best against North Carolina in 85 in Hopkins this year.
This five-goal deficit, as we've said before, Dave, not impossible to really come back quickly on in a lacrosse game. But Brown's got to start doing it now.
Jamie Monroe. We saw Brown take one outside shot. That was by this man, Gagnon, number four. To Buonanno, the feed to Monroe. He swiped at it, missed. Now Syracuse runs it up. Tom Nelson in the middle of the field. He's got Mapes down low. He shoots and scores.
This is a real fancy shot. Obviously, just got the fast break, got the steps going in. Before, they looked maybe for Nelson to dish it off. Nelson did not. He's kind of holding the stick. Where am I going to go with it? And then he just took the shot and went right over the right shoulder of Lyon.
And the wide side of the net was actually to the other side.
Absolutely right. Yeah, he went to the short side, and but he did a nice job of faking whether he's going to pass it or not.
Look at this face-off. Jurgle and Manown.
Somebody might be withholding the ball from play. We'll see what happens.
Procedure call, we'll give it to Brown.
Always a good call on that. You can never make a mistake on one of those stepping on the stick or push. That was a real standoff in there, but we'll have Brown with the opportunity now to get back in at 6:49 left.
Crowd of 2,462 watching as Syracuse has scored two in a row. They lead it now 9-3. Ranked number two in the country is Syracuse, Brown number 11. Last year, Brown was as high as number six. Jamie Monroe lost the ball.
This is what Syracuse has done all day, those big sticks.
Dan Pratt wings it cross field to Nelson. He waited for the cutters to fill the middle. Now Mapes gets it to Zulberti. Here's a cutter, Nelson. Picks up the ground ball, gets out of trouble. Tried to feed the crease. Tough angle for Gordie Mapes. It's out of bounds and Brown ball.
You know, one of the things we talked about, Syracuse losing the faceoffs, But then they come back and do what they did right there, which is have their big stick middies on. They knock the ball on, intercept the pass, and just start it back up. They've been overcoming that. But, Dave, as the season goes on, I think that the paucity of faceoffs, that the big difference between what Syracuse gets and what the opponent gets, could be a large factor.
Low in the goalie, gets it to Muller. Now in the middle to Keogh. And they overthrow Gagnon. It's going to be played by Desko. He sends it back toward the middle, up high to get it, is Badwini. Chris Badwini, number 22. Chris Bird is 33. Syracuse sending on Eric Jeschke. Now Tom Corey from behind the cage. Let's see if he goes one-on-one. He's got Muller, the excellent defenseman, playing him. Pat Donahue comes on, immediately gets the feed from Corey. Now Jeschke, and it is Mapes and Corey. He's going to try to blow by Muller. Stops on a dime, loses it in the crease to Lowen. He gets it out to Rogers. Greg Rogers, 44, guarded by Pat Donahue. Spivey heads toward the bench. Abbott comes on, watched by Burke. Bonanno still with the ball now behind the net.
They're trying to clear out for Bonanno. They couldn't, and he drew a crowd, so he had to get rid of the ball.
And he gets it to Gagnon. He works one-on-one, pops to a knee, comes back up. Looks for the angle, and it's saved by Guyari. Ricocheted way out to Rogers, rolling into the Syracuse bench out of bounds. Brown will keep it.
And Jimmy Guyari just doing a little bit of talking to his defense. He did a nice job. I think it hit the pipe. It bounced like it hit the pipe.
Rogers walks it in. Into the box now. He goes to Gagnon. 4 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Quarter number three. Buonanno and Gagnon. Clayton Jones open in front. Abbott's in there. Here's Rogers. Syracuse blocking the pass. Desko doing it and coming away with it. He'll bring it across. He feeds it to Mapes. Open net for Corey.
Nice teamwork. This is the midseason form you want to see out of your people on a fast break. They get the ball down and they're always looking, got their eyes open. And there is Desko, who's the big sticker, got it off. And now we're looking for somebody open. What a pass from Mapes into Corey, 42.
You saw five men, five brown shirts, rotate to Gordie Mapes, and they forgot all about Tom Corey.
The goal is by number 42, Tom Corey.
Suarez controlling the faceoff. It's a 10-3 game.
The goal by 42, Corey. Assist.
Suarez looking for help now. He got the faceoff. Now he wants somebody to give it to.
Brown.
Tom Corey with a goal and two assists in the game. He's moving toward the all-time Syracuse goal mark and the 200-point mark for his career as Gary saves and sticks it out to Stadelmeyer, and quickly a procedure call.
That's still stays Syracuse ball. One of those calls where you say, gee, it could have stopped a fast break, but you got to make the call, and that's exactly what happened. Syracuse will get the ball just over the midfield line, and number 21, Rossi, will handle it for Syracuse.
That goal for Tom Corey, number 124, Tom Abbott, has the Syracuse all-time record at 141. Next in sight for Mr. Corey, Tim O'Hara at 125, and then Brad Kotz at 129. Some great names in Syracuse lacrosse history, and Nelson scores. He faked with everything. The hip bone, the thigh bone, the Adam's apple, the shoulder.
I don't think he really knew exactly if he had the ball checked out of his stick, so he kept making the moves and dumped it by for an easy goal, making it number 11 for the Orange, as they now really jump out to a long lead here by 8 with 3:13 left to go in the third quarter.
It was a 7-2 game of the half. Brown moved to within 4 at 7-3, and Syracuse has now scored the last 4 in a row. Manown and Is that Brannigan on the faceoff?
No, it was number 26. It's Donahue.
Tom Corey. Todd Curry. Eric Jeschke. When time permits, we'll tell you how you can write us for a chance of winning World Cup lacrosse tickets. 11-3 is the score. Hard shot, Donahue. So Syracuse continues to pour it on here in the third quarter. Their fifth goal of this session.
But now number 19 was doing the guarding. They'll get the ball way out on top to Donahue, but not there in time, and he just took a hard one hopper over the shoulder of the goalie.
Round one's time with 2:43 to go, and Syracuse leading it by a score of 12-3. We'll be back with more after these words.
Imagine living in a place surrounded by acres of natural beauty, where old world charm isn't a thing of the past, where children have room to grow, and where four superb seasons offer a variety of opportunities to be explored year round. Imagine living in a place like this. You do.
You got a share in Syracuse. You got a share in Syracuse, New York.
Harry, stop trying to do your taxes all by yourself.
Harry, we called the IRS and found out there's a tax aid program right down the street, so come on.
Come on, let's go.
We should tell him it's free.
It's free?
Call your local IRS office and ask for the tax aid program nearest you.
And here's the address to write. Send us a postcard. World Cup Lacrosse, care of McCaw Cablevision, 500 South Salina Street, Syracuse, New York, 13202. World Cup Lacrosse this summer in Toronto. Right now, the face-off with 2:43 to go in the third quarter. Suarez popped it in the air, and coming down with it is Eric Jeschke. Played loosely by Appleton, now Donahue.
I was just going to say, Dave, Smith, the man we talked about at the top of the show, made a couple of appearances early, has not really been back into the faceoffs.
There's an open avenue for Curry, gave up the shot, and Mapes got the nice pass but couldn't capitalize. Appleton now with the ball for Brown. Spins by Curry, loses control, gets it back. He's dumped on the sideline, the late call coming up, and now the whistle. It's against Syracuse.
Unnecessary roughness. And Curry will sit down.
By the way, we've had an excellent response to our World Cup lacrosse ticket giveaway, and we'll tell you before this game is over about other winners. Where they've come from, we'll be sending tickets out to them, and we'll send them to you, too. Just drop us a postcard, care of McCaw Cablevision, 500 South Salina Street, Syracuse, New York, 13202. Man up now for Brown. Under 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Catalo losing it to Burke.
That has happened all day on that situation. Syracuse playing very tough, man down, not allowing a man down goal. Syracuse has not in this game.
It's out of bounds, and Brown will keep it.
Syracuse has been known for playing very tough man down. They gave up one man down goal out of seven, so not bad. They have been playing man down quite a bit. Lots of penalties in this game.
Bonanno back to Gagnon. Hard shot. Guiry was there, and Guiry's got it in the crease.
That's dangerous right there. There was somebody from Brown around, and they just kind of tried to get the ball into Guiry, but number 11 from Brown was right there, Keogh. And that is going to remain Brown ball.
Bonanno sends out to Stedman. Back to Bonanno. Gagnon, Keogh is double teamed every time he steps in the slot. There's a feed to Stedman. He fanned on it. Gagnon's going to go back and play it.
Syracuse a little bit out of position.
Tries to do it himself, and the shot is wide, but Brown keeps it again.
And on that, Syracuse will even up with 105 left in the third quarter, so both teams at full strength. We said Syracuse now giving up one of eight on extra man situations. And that's pretty impressive if you can keep that stat all year. There's a look from the end zone, and you'll see the Syracuse defense, which has played tough all day, now going to kind of a zone look as they shift around. Playing zone now.
Keo has it, sending it way out to Stedman, who had to reverse the stick to catch it. A hard shot, and Guyrie was right there. Cataldo fired that one, and Guyrie pulled it in. Chris Burt, unsettled situation. Syracuse looks to capitalize.
Clock's on the field, 25 seconds left.
Bedwini is down in the attacking end. O'Donnell comes off for Curry, who comes on and gets the pass.
Syracuse only got 15 seconds and still changing midfielders.
Curry beats his man, feeds it to Badwini with 6 seconds to go. And Muller, with some fancy footwork, will run the clock out.
Nice check at the end by 28 Sheehan.
And so the end of three quarters, Syracuse dominating Brown, 12-3. So you want to play the game? Then you've got to go to the Varsity Sports Shop, the largest supplier of lacrosse equipment in Central New York, including Brian's famous shotgun and super light, or STX Excalibur or laser light, plus helmets, gloves, and pads. Everything you need to play the game, any game. Varsity stocks a complete line of sporting goods and supplies, fine athletic footwear, and school jackets. Mention this Cable 13 ad and take 10% off anything in the store. Varsity Sports Shop, Vernon Avenue, just west of Midler.
Tradition has always been at the heart of Syracuse University lacrosse. The great athletes that played on earlier teams shared the same pride and victory that my teammates and I do. I'm Brad Kotz, and I played for the Orange. For me, winning the NCAA championship was an experience I'll never forget. It's hard to describe the feeling you get representing your school and the community you grew up in. Thanks, Syracuse, for all you do for SU athletics.
Fourth quarter set to begin, but before that, we'll look at the action that ended quarter number three as Muller ran out the clock, lost his stick, and then was knocked to the turf.
That has been indicative of both teams. And we'll look at the third quarter stats, shots even, saves 19. Guyrie having a good day. Ground ball, Syracuse picking up a little bit on that. Man up goals, one, as we said, for Brown, one of eight.
Jeske off the face, sending it back to Curry. Fourth quarter, Syracuse 12 and round three.
Brown have a little problem getting their offense on track. Syracuse has forced them into that kind of a settled situation. They have not given them a lot of opportunities to fast break it. And as we said, the Syracuse close defense and those big stick minis have done a nice job today.
Curry was leaned on there by Appleton. Syracuse averaging about 15 goals a game, and they're right on target for hitting 15 today. In close, Donahue fan on the pass from Nelson. Nelson takes a real run at McComas and still sticks to him. Bounce feed to Suarez on the sideline, and he loses it.
Both teams hustling. Still, Brown, as we said, a team maybe a little bit over the head this year against Syracuse, but it's early in the season, about the midway point for both teams. And of course, Brown looking at that Ivy League crown.
Todd Curry runs it in. And now backs it off.
They got
Muller is on him.
They have five men within 10 yards of the crease.
These two men could be teammates in the World Cup this summer. That was intended for Donahue, who didn't know it was coming. Jeske sticked it back. Nice behind-the-back pass to Nelson. Syracuse whipping it around with Corey. McComas gives him a ride.
He's going to get jumped.
He feeds. The backhand shot hit the crossbar. Corey goes for the rebound, and he gets it.
Offense really putting it together in this run.
Curry calls for it now. He gets it. Settles down the team. Eric Jeschke to Tom Nelson.
They move Nelson behind. Let's see if he deals or looks for somebody to dish off to.
He's played by Appleby. Faking the behind-the-back pass. Faking, going down. Backhands it in the net. What a shot. And that wipes out the penalty.
Well, and the goalie was trying to play defense. You'll see that if we see the replay. Watch him get his stick out there and try to play a little bit of defense on Nelson. It's just simply a move all the way. He took it from one side, came all the way. Now he's starting back. Behind the back pass. Fake. Watch the goalie. Watch Lowen come out. And now he's down on the ground. He backhands it again.
He was falling down to his left and backhanded it to his right. What a great shot by Tom Nelson. Nelson coming up with a goal. It's 13-3.
Leland Rogers.
Third goal of this game.
Leland Rogers just in on the faceoff, Dave. Just going to say they've three or four people seen action. Rogers, the transfer, the wrestler, could not come up with it. And Brown, however, lost control, and Syracuse has it again.
Three goals. Nelson's high for this season. His career high is five. Nelson also with an assist. So Syracuse now out to a 13-3 lead. Corey moving on Rogers, feeding Neil Ault, gets it down low to Nelson. Here's another goal.
Nelson going crazy here in this fourth quarter. Once again, just a move.
Syracuse's goal.
Where he just comes back, watch him come around, fakes that low hand shot, and then jumps up in the air and takes him to the short side. Once again, Leland Rogers in there. Now he's come up with a faceoff. He got it out the last time. He's big and strong.
Leland Rogers, a former NCAA Division III national wrestling champ, a transfer from St. Lawrence University to Syracuse during this academic year.
They're trying to work some people in a faceoff. Syracuse looking for some people that are going to help them as they head into the real tough part of the season. Well, they've already had some early games, but they want to maintain that consistency. And as we said, faceoffs have been a problem.
Scott Lowen in the goal all game long. He was an All-American player a year ago.
McComas stripped Syracuse of the ball. They're going to get a fast break opportunity.
In the middle, it's Spivey. He's a transfer out of North Carolina. Spivey gave up the shot and then threw it behind Gagnon. And Brown's become a little bit unsettled at this point.
Spivey, good speed, but made a poor pass on that, and that will really put a lot more pressure on Brown. 11:46 left.
Don't forget, get us your postcards or letters in the mail for a shot at winning World Cup lacrosse tickets. The tournament features the U.S., Canada, England, Australia, and it'll be in the great city of Toronto this summer.
Sheehan once again with the ball for Syracuse. The defenseman trying to clear it. It's going to get it checked away. Nice job by Gagnon.
Sheehan gets the pass back from Dan Pratt. Now Jim Guyery. 11:20 to go in this game. Right now, the three goals represents the fewest any team has scored against Syracuse this year. And you would not have expected that from Brown, a pretty good offensive team. Curry to Nelson, down to Zulberti, behind the cage, Corey. Tom Corey works one-on-one, shovels it back to Zulberti, he'll shoot, saved nicely by Lowen. Up ahead to Muller. Zulberti chases him. Muller's going to take it coast to coast. Beautiful feed, the shot, and it misses.
Guyery, I think, got a bottom of a stick on it. I think he deflected it.
Was it Gagnon who had the shot, and he missed it at point-blank range?
Bonanno upset and complaining that Syracuse got the ball. See if we can see. There's Muller, 28. Good speed. You can see why he's going to be a world team member. There's the ball passed aside. And there's Gagnon. Let's see the shot. I think he got a leg on it. I think Guyery had a spectacular save on that. Gagnon blocked it with his body, the shot that is, but the television shot. But I think that Gyrie got a leg on it.
14-3 as Gyrie goes to the far sideline now. In the middle, it's Jeschke. He's running it right toward the box. Now he throws it to Zulberti. Donahue is in the slot along with Tom Nelson. Curry at the point, back to Jeschke. A little double stack there in front, Donahue and Nelson. Now Curry, he'll crank. Oh, what a bullet.
I expected to see it come out the other side. Lots of local fans here from West Genesee. And the Syracuse fans in general really treated to an exhibition of power shooting by Curry as he takes this from out on the right as you look at it, and he just powers it by Scott Lowen, the goalie.
And for Todd Curry, his fifth goal of the game, and that is a career high for Todd Curry.
Goal by number 16, Todd Curry. Assist number 11, Aaron Jeschke. Syracuse 15, Brown.
I think he was with Holt. Wait, we got a push. That'll go towards the Syracuse goal. Is Brown.
Leland Rogers gets into it now. Rogers gets into it with Heffernan. Heffernan will be in a decided disadvantage against a national wrestling champion.
He already lost the takedown.
He's down and was pinned. This is the first time all season we've seen any outbreak like this, and it's going to take a couple of people, I think, to corral Leland Rogers.
Well, they must have said something to each other because they both just stood right up and went at it after the face-off attempt. That's number 31, Brian Heffernan, talking to the officials, and we'll be right back to sort this all out for you in just a couple of seconds.
It was a feeling started long ago, one bleak and wintry morn, when the call went out for volunteers in a nation being born. No sunshine, patriot speeches, no summer soldiers. With a special man who'd pay the price to keep the country strong. When we were needed, we were there. We were there when we were needed, we were there. No, it wasn't always easy, wasn't always fair. But when freedom called, we answered, we were there. No, it wasn't always easy.
Back in the Carrier Dome, we've had a little bit of an extracurricular flurry that has cost each team one player. Number 10, Leland Rogers, ejected from the game for Syracuse, and number 31, I believe, Brian Heffernan, was tossed out of the game for Brown. A PA announcement was that another player was thrown out of the game, Chris Essen player, but I don't believe he even made the trip. So we'll go with the principals being ejected. 9:44 to go, 15-3 Syracuse lead. Keo really blanketed there by Desco. Pitch set by Gagnon, but he couldn't use it too well. Hard shot, and Gyrie with a brilliant save.
He's been on today. Gyrie's having a super game. One thing this does, they're both even, but it really opens the game up because the field is not as crowded.
Stadelmeyer took that pass in transition. Now cross field to Burt. He'll crank low, and good save by Lowen. There's a hip check thrown by Stadelmeyer against number 41, John Ireland. And Brown will get possession. 9 minutes and 12 seconds to go in this game. Reed Overby comes on. Ireland sits down.
Incidentally, while before Leland was asked to leave, he had four faceoff attempts and won all four, so he is perhaps coming on, using him a little bit more as the game progresses.
Out of your picture on the sideline, three Syracuse players, looks like Jeske, Curry, and Pat Donahue are choosing something among them, shooting fingers. Maybe it's who comes on or who gets the next shot.
Ball up in the air.
Loose play now. Gyrie lost his defensive help momentarily. The cage has been rattled, and Bird intercepts the pass from behind the net.
He's also had a nice game. These big stick people have been really playing well for Syracuse.
Got to find out what they were choosing there with the odd finger on the sideline. Jeske, Donahue, and Curry.
The Curry players are a strange group, Dave.
Spivey comes on with Curry. Syracuse works from behind the cage. 8 minutes, 10 seconds left. Must have been who would come on the field. Because Curry came on, now Donahue comes on.
And Jeske's next, so what?
Don't know if it was the odd finger in or the odd finger out.
Those three-minute penalties.
Corey loses it. It rolls right into the stick of Lowen. Syracuse 15, Brown 3.
Both teams still down a man, and they will be for the entire 3 minutes.
Muller comes back to get the pass from Lowen. Moving back there. Going by number 15 in the game, Peter Allen. Syracuse beginning now to get some fresh players in the game.
As I said, this really opens.
Overbeek goes by the check attempt of Zulberti, who picks up his stick.
Really opens the game up because with two less people, there's a lot more room to cover and run and play defense.
Bonanno tried the jump shot, and Syracuse played it well. Whistle stops things. A hold, I believe, called against Syracuse will give the ball back to Brown.
7:02 left in the fourth quarter, the end of the game. As the score is not in doubt, I don't think, in terms of who's going to win, but they've got a goalie warming up there for Syracuse.
That's Rhett Cavanaugh, number 13, who will not see action, I don't believe, warming up Joe Ryan, number 6, who probably will see action.
They set a pick there, and he didn't move out of the way, and Syracuse just clobbered him, and we're going to see some more clobbering as we're going to get a little sloppy here at the end.
Gagnon lost the handle on the shot. The ball rolled in the crease. And Gyrie, quick as a cat, pounced on it.
Sheehan detected now for bringing a body check up a little bit higher than it should be. Unnecessary roughness, and that's going to Syracuse be down a minute. Now you talk about opening the field up, but they're still down a man. Now they're going to be down actually only one man in terms of relative strength, but the field should be wide open. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right now, we'll see if someone else steps on. Syracuse playing with 7 men.
We have 6:48 to go in the game. And we'll remind those of you watching on Home Team Sports. Cable 13. Our next game will have Syracuse playing at Cornell. Check the time and listing in your area. Timeout taken. Syracuse leads it 15-3.
Imagine living in a place where the sports action never stops, where amateurs and professionals meet and compete in a variety of events, where 4 superb seasons of fun guarantee that nobody loses, no matter what sport they like, and where winning is a tradition. Imagine living in a place like this. You do.
To do your taxes all by yourself.
Harry, we called the IRS and found out there's a tax aid program right down the street, so come on.
Let's go.
We should tell him it's free.
It's free?
Call your local IRS office and ask for the tax aid program nearest you.
Action picks up, 6:45 to go. Looks like a two-man advantage right now for Brown.
Syracuse has eight men on the field.
Intercepted by the Syracuse defense. Pratt, he's going to come out of there with it.
Good run. They should get the ball in the box. He's got to stay onside. No, they don't. Ball is down. No possession.
And here comes Brown with Catalo getting it to Buonanno. Steve Scaramuzzino is off for Syracuse. Here's a point-blank attempt, and it goes over the cage. John Keogh missed it.
A three-minute penalty must have elapsed. Brown has a full complement of folks out there.
They have a two-man advantage on Syracuse right now. Here's a hard shot, knocked down at the point again. Keogh and Guyrie gets it and pulls it into the crease. And he gets it upfield in the middle. Scaramuzzino lost it. And here comes Stepman. Coming all the way in, he shoots, he scores. Not much Jim Guyrie could do about that.
Absolutely not. He just was at the mercy of Stedman because the ball was down and nobody could even put a stick up on Stedman to slow him down. And he just took a real hard shot. Jim Guyrie feels badly about it. But watch, there's Stedman, 37. Down it goes.
You know, the eighth goal of the year for Stedman.
You got to respect Guyrie that even though the game's he's really working on it, still wants to make sure that he gets the ball and stops those goals. New faceoff man, Jerome Hall, in for Syracuse.
220-pound football player, linebacker for Syracuse. Doesn't come up with a face, but it is taken by the orange man, Earl Hall, number 7. And he overthrows his man on the sideline there, Sander Friedman. So lots of new jerseys coming on for Syracuse, and now departing.
Syracuse coming on a little bit here in the faceoff department. They actually controlled that one, came up with it, but lost the ball to Brown.
5.5 minutes to go. Scott Lowen's been in all the way in the nets for Brown. 15-4 game.
As we look at that, you can see the faceoff statistic is sometimes misleading. It means that you're getting the ball and supposedly controlling the game, but if you get it taken away from you shortly thereafter, which is what Syracuse has been doing, you can still really play good lacrosse. That's Syracuse concern down the line. Shot.
Real hard shot by Abbott, and Guyrie made the save. Maybe the hardest shot of the game.
Guyrie has been super in the goal today. There's a call. There's a procedure call. I didn't see exactly who it was on. Should be Syracuse ball. They're going to clear it. Sheehan back in the game. Number 28, who has the ball right now and now passes way over to Desco.
On the far sideline, it's Earl Hall, number 7. Open on the near sideline is Pratt. He's going to get the pass now. And bring it across. Down he goes to Zulberti. Syracuse has Nelson in the slot. Zulberti works one-on-one against McComas. Knocked out of his stick. And played by Spivey. 4 minutes, 20 seconds left.
Brown going to go back to Lowen, the goalie, to set it up.
Stadelmeyer runs on for Syracuse, 24. Reed Overby. Muller is really a very offensive-minded defenseman. Now Abbott has it. Also coming out is Greg Rogers. We're under 4 minutes to go.
Little one-on-one now. Now, if I were Coach Simmons, I might take my goalie out now. He's had a real good game. You don't want him to lose his confidence by giving up maybe some cheap goals at the end. Obviously, the game is not in jeopardy, but I think that he's had such a good game, you might want to get him out of there and leave him with the good game intact.
On the other hand, with Brown coming in with a reputation as a very good offensive team and Gary going all the way and looking so good, give them the complete game.
That's another side of it.
Buonanno really been held in check today. Pratt doing the job on him in this particular trip. Keogh also has been held in check. Out to the point, hard shot coming. Defenseman Sheehan, who is in the crease, deflected it over the far sideline. 3 minutes and 5 seconds left.
He has just had a super game for Syracuse. The whole defense and big stick middies have just played superbly for Syracuse.
Now Gagnon. Keogh helped out in there again, and a hard shot that hits the side of the cage and rolls beyond the end line. The scoring for Brown in this game, Buonanno, assisted by Jones in the first quarter. Gagnon, assisted by Keogh in the third. Gagnon also had a goal assisted by Buonanno in the first quarter. And Stedman unassisted.
That's going to cost Sheen another minute. You know, he's probably been out 6 minutes in the game. He had the 3 minute. I think this is his, well, this is going to only be a 30-second job. Of course, five personals can put you out of a lacrosse team. And Sheehan is going to sit down. He is going to get a nice round of applause because the fans here at Syracuse know what a good job he did in this game. And Jimmy Guiry, as I suspected, is out.
So Syracuse finally does replace the goalie. Jim Guiry got off the field in a hurry, getting tremendous congratulations at the Syracuse bench and from the crowd. There's Joe Ryan in the nets, another West Genesee product, 15-4.
Guiry leaves, incidentally, with 26 saves. I think a real good game for Jim Guiry.
Stedman, Buonanno. Stedman again, cross field, hard shot. Good save there by Joe Ryan. 2:18 left.
Ryan, the goalies are always tough to make. You really have to work hard. They worked hard with Guiry while Nims was here, and now they've got Ryan in. They've signed a good one who'll be a freshman next year. Matt Pelham out of the area, high school, Jamesville DeWitt.
Ryan is 6 inches shorter than the man he replaced in the Nets, Guiry. There's a bounce shot. Cataldo misses.
We talked before about goalies, and sometimes people would like to say, gee, if you're a taller goalie, he's probably going to be better, but I've seen him both ways. And Ryan, not, as you said, as tall as Jim Guiry.
Just a couple of people who have not seen action yet for Brown in this game. Number 9, Carl Weatherly White. And number 21, Cormac Malloy. Gary Walker, number 17, also has not played yet.
Desco.
And Joe Ryan down to play it.
Desco on Keogh, just took it away in a weak shot. Ryan's got it.
Ryan out of the nets. Still with it. Has it deflected in the air, it's out of bounds. It's going to be Brown ball. No, Syracuse ball.
Close along that sideline, and a referee, Jim O'Hara, made the call.
There are a couple of Brown fans down in the seats to the lower right of the screen there as the ball is scooped up by Dan Pratt. With a minute, 25 seconds left.
Jerome Hall.
Ball is quite a bit bigger now than when he last played lacrosse for Henninger High School on a state championship team.
Lifting weights for 4 years will do that to you.
Tom Smallhorn, number 30, is in the game.
Clock's on the field.
Under a minute to go. John Zulberti losing to Muller.
Nice
Muller
check.
Losing it. Back to Zulberti, and it rolls across now.
Good check by Zulberti. Muller checked from behind. 47 seconds left. See what they get everybody in and out. A lot of people seeing playing time for Syracuse also.
Syracuse goes on the road to Cornell next week. Brown will play at Cornell later in the year.
As we said, Brown in contention for that Ivy League crown.
And a score by Sander Friedman.
Sander Friedman, a junior out of Scotch Plains, New Jersey.
Syracuse goal.
It's a one-on-one.
25, Sander Friedman.
He was working on number 23, Reed Overby, and he gets by Overby, takes the right-handed shot for Syracuse's 16th goal with 31 seconds left in the game.
That probably is the first goal of Sander Friedman's career, certainly this season.
Face-off Hall up with it.
Jerome Hall has it knocked away as he comes upfield. At one time, Syracuse used to have many, many football players out for lacrosse, but spring practice nowadays and just the change in the game, the emphasis on speed, and the fact that so many football players, as you said, Dale, do become heavily muscled, has made it a smaller man's game.
Unless you can get a wide receiver or something like that, generally you're right, or a defensive back. We get linebackers and linemen, and you said it right, Dave, but just awful big and maybe not as fast as you need to be in this game.
Yeah, that is the first goal scored by Sander Friedman, the junior out of Scotch Plains, New Jersey. Here's Zulberti coming in, feeding, and a score.
Nice luck by Zulberti to number 23, hotailing the freshman out of Baldwinsville, New York.
So he sets up hotailing for his first goal.
Very unselfish, I think, of Zulberti. Zulberti could have taken the shot. He had blown out of the goal, but he dishes it off, and hotailing knew what to do with it when he got it. A diving attempt by Lowen to save it, but he just couldn't do anything on the fast break. 8 seconds left.
And so this face-off should end things. And it does. The end of the game, and Syracuse has soundly defeated Brown University by a 17-4 score. We'll be back with more after this.
Tradition has always been at the heart of Syracuse University's lacrosse. The great athletes that played on earlier teams shared the same pride and victory that my teammates and I do. I'm Brad Kotz, and I played for the Orange. For me, winning the NCAA championship was an experience I'll never forget. It's hard to describe the feeling you get representing your school and the community you grew up in. Thanks, Syracuse, for all you do for SU athletics.
Championship game 3 years in a row. Will 1986 be the year that Syracuse regains the title? Stay with Cable 13 all season long for coverage of each and every Syracuse home game and KOA contest at Cornell and Hobart. Curry, Corey, Kavanaugh, and Cable 13. La Creme de la Crosse.
Harry, stop trying to do your taxes all by yourself. Come on down to the AARP Tax Aid program with us.
Yeah, Harry. Tax Aid is sponsored by the American Association of Retired Persons.
Harry, we called the IRS and found out there's a tax aid program right down the street. So come on.
Oh, come on, let's go.
We should tell him it's free.
It's free?
Call your local IRS office and ask for the tax aid program nearest you.
So you want to play the game? Then you've got to go to the Varsity Sports Shop, the largest supplier of lacrosse equipment in Central New York, including Brian's famous shotgun and Super Light, or STX Excalibur or Laser Light, plus helmets, gloves, and pads. Everything you need to play the game, any game. Varsity stocks a complete line of sporting goods and supplies, fine athletic footwear, and school jackets. Mention this Cable 13 ad and take 10% off anything in the store. Varsity Sports Shop, Vernon Avenue, just west of Midler. And back in the Carrier Dome, it's all over. Syracuse, an easy winner over Brown by a 17-4 score. Brown scoring one goal in each quarter today. Syracuse with a win now goes to 7-1 on the year. Brown falls to 4-3. Dave Cohen along with Dale Dreipulcher, hope you enjoyed it. A disappointing game certainly for Brown fans, but as we said at the start, they were definitely stepping up in class and competition, and they had to know that this was something that could occur.
Well, you know, I think Syracuse scored 17 goals, but the thing that really took Brown out of their game was the big stick middies and the close defense for Syracuse just knocked the ball down. They had opportunities. They had faceoffs early, but Syracuse defense just did a great job of getting the ball back. And when they got a chance, they took advantage of it, Dave. So Brown played pretty well, but Syracuse defense was tough today, as was Guyrie. He had a super game.
Easily the best game I think I've seen him play in his stint in his career at Syracuse. The scoring star today for the Orange Men, no doubt about it, was Todd Curry. He has missed a couple of games this year because of a pulled hamstring. It's been a recurring injury. But today, in the man-to-man defense against single coverage, he really came out firing, and he had a career-high 5 goals. We're going to take a look at some of the offense provided by Todd Curry.
Curry, as we said, had been out for a couple of games, and he came back with a vengeance. I thought it might take him a little while to get back in the swing of things, but he was really putting a real hard shot by today, and no finesse in terms of, kind of the behind the back. He just wound up and cranked. 5 goals and assist, a super comeback game for Todd Curry. He's got to be very pleased, as does Coach Simmons.
Tom Nelson had 4 goals and 1 assist as Syracuse really poured it on with 7 goals in the first half. Then they came back with 10 goals in the second half. After Brown had actually scored the first goal in each half, Syracuse came back and they ran away with it 17-4. I told you earlier we had some winners of World Cup lacrosse tickets. Don't want to forget to pass those along. From La Plata, Maryland, where they're watching on Home Team Sports, Doug Douglas is a winner. From Liverpool, New York, Carrie Quilty, where she watches on new channels on Cable 13. And from Saranac Lake, where Rich Brown is watching on his cable dish, he himself has won 2 tickets. So we'll get those tickets out in the mail to Doug Douglas in La Plata, Maryland, Carrie Quilty in Liverpool, and Rich Brown in Saranac Lake, and tell you can get us a postcard and get in the running to win World Cup lacrosse tickets. So once again, the final score is Syracuse winning over Brown 17-4. Today's game has been brought to you by the Varsity Sports Shop, headquarters for all your lacrosse needs. By Genesee Beer, the great outdoors in a glass. By DiNardo Ford, your Southwest County Ford dealer. By Tops to Please, if it says Syracuse, we've got it. And by Penn Can Mall, the mall that's got it all. Today's game was produced and directed by Gary Mariano. Our coordinating producer, Bob Jubinville. By remote supervisor, Andy Swite. And the rest of the people at McCaw Cablevision in Syracuse. Now speaking for Dale Dreipulcher and our statistician, Karen Ryan, this is Dave Cohen thanking you for joining us and reminding you to be with us next week for Cornell and Syracuse on most of these same stations. This has been a presentation of Cable 13 Sports and McCaw Cable Vision of Syracuse, the leader in local sports television.
Since the beginning of time, man has looked to the skies and wondered whether he is alone. In the new film, 2010, the wonder of making contact becomes a reality. end of the screen involved a massive team effort, both in front of and behind the cameras. In creating a unique view of life in space, the cast and crew worked under unprecedented security for more than a year on the project. Their goal was to bring Arthur C. Clarke's amazing story of discovery to life.
Well, I think there is a natural...